Hey guys, 98 Sports Talk here with my outlook for South Carolina in the 2018 season. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments section. If you guys think I'm off or I missed something, or if you just think my record prediction is bogus or if I'm on target. But let me know and give it a thumbs up if you liked the video. So let's get into it. Last season, South Carolina was 8-4 and 5-3 in the SEC. And overall, I think it was a pretty good season. I think you could say that South Carolina was trending up under Will Muschamp and, exceeded expectations for last season. Recruiting-wise, South Carolina had some holes to fill on the offensive and defensive line and defense in general. Two of Will Muschamp's biggest recruits were Dylan Wonnum and Rick Sandage, two big defensive tackles, probably Inyon. I'll get into this in a second. Both those guys are probably going to have to play. Offensively, we've got Jake Bentley coming back. Jake seems to have a lot of talent and will no doubt be a future, probably top 10 NFL draft pick. But right now he seems to, I can't figure him out. It's like he's got all this talent, but he just hasn't kind of, I guess, put it all together. So let's see if, he takes a next step and improves. If he does, then my prediction probably will be low. If he does, kind of what he's been doing, I'm guessing, South Carolina will have a similar kind of offense and be on, a similar path to what I'm thinking here. But offensively, again, South Carolina loses pretty much everybody on the offensive line. So they're going to have to replace a lot of guys, and they lack a little bit of depth offensively. So offensively, I think they'll take probably a slight step back since they've got to replace so many people. South Carolina does get Deebo Samuel back. I think he's only played, 18 games thus far for the Gamecocks. So, he's one of the guys that he can kind of, make a big difference, make a huge impact on this offense. So if he can stay healthy, South Carolina's offense might improve, even though they lost a lot of guys on the offensive line. But we'll see if Deebo Samuel can stay healthy. So overall, I think the offense probably will be maybe about the same. Jake Bentley might take a slight step up, but losing all those guys on the offensive line really hurts. Defensively, South Carolina loses a lot of talent, a lot of starters that need to be replaced. So I think on this side of the ball, it's got to be a step back. Defensive line is a big issue, as I told you about in recruiting. Some of these freshmen are going to have to come in and maybe even start or play immediately for South Carolina, play a lot of minutes. So depth on, both lines is an issue, and that's never a good thing when you're talking about any football team, and especially, SEC teams. It's just not going to be good. So I think they're going to take a step back defensively. Let's get into the schedule here. South Carolina starts out with Coastal Carolina. That's going to be a win. We know that. But then they play UGA at home. Georgia is coming off a national title game and looks to be loaded up for 2018. So I don't see South Carolina winning that one. South Carolina should get a win at Marshall. Then they play Vandy in Kentucky next. Both of those games are on the road, but I'm going to guess South Carolina wins both of those games. Now here's where it kind of, I don't want to say it gets dicey, but here's where, games could go either way for South Carolina. They play Missouri, Texas A&M, then a bye, and then Tennessee. So those three games, I kind of look at those three games as being swing games. I think, the games will be evenly matched. And whether or not, South Carolina can win those games along with a game later on down the road at Florida, I think that's going to determine South Carolina's season. I'm going to guess Missouri, A&M, Tennessee, and Florida, I'm going to guess that South Carolina goes 2-2 in those games. And so, but we'll see. They could go 0-4, which I doubt. They could also win all four of them. I don't think they'll do that either. But I think 2-2 is pretty realistic for those four games. After the Tennessee game, South Carolina takes on Ole Miss. That's at Ole Miss. I do think they'll beat Ole Miss. And then round, you know, again, then they got on the road at Florida, and then rounding out the season at UT Chattanooga and Clemson. I think, you know, they'll beat UT Chattanooga and then lose to Clemson again. South Carolina fans won't like to hear me saying that, but I do think Clemson will beat them. So basically, looking at their schedule, I think it's going to be, you know, 6-2, I think is I can call pretty definitively with, you know, again, losses at Clemson and Georgia. And then those swing games that I talked about will really kind of make or break South Carolina's season. And I'm predicting South Carolina will go 2-2 in those games and thus end up with an 8-4 record overall. So, like I said, let me know what you guys think about my 8-4 prediction for South Carolina. I think overall, you know, they will have the same record. I think they'll probably go downhill, you know, just slightly from where they were last season, just due to, you know, depth on the offensive line and defensive line, and just on the defense in general. But again, let me know what you guys think down in the comment section. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. Doing all kinds of SEC videos, and you know, we'll see you guys in the next video.